There you go, little guy. And only 800 more frames to go.
No way I'm getting through tonight without some coffee. Probably some downstairs.
Time for a little adventure. Really? They locked me in. Good thing I brought my own key today. Who put this here? Whew. Here's the key. The most welcoming hallway I've ever seen. Hello? Is someone there? You scared me to death.
I'm sorry, my dear. Didn't mean to frighten you. You're working late tonight. A pretty girl like you shouldn't be wandering around all by yourself. Mind if I step in?
Of course not.
Thank you. Audrey, you look like you could use a little company.
So, it's been really nice this past week.
Just beautiful. Gorgeous.
What was that? Please tell me we're not trapped in here.
Don't you worry, my dear. It's just a little short in the system. Happening a lot these past few days. No need to fret. Let's see what we can find. Come along now. Old Wilson will protect you. Just a few more switches to throw. Follow me. It will be perfectly safe. Looks like someone's been messing with the exhibits. There should be something on each of these pedestals. Audrey. Sweet Audrey. Do an old man a favor and go find them. I'll tend to the power. Only one thing left to do. Pull that switch. It is done.
Wilson?
Oh, Audrey. The things you've set in motion.
What's happening?
The ink is calling us, my dear. Can't you hear it?
What?
Shh. Don't fret. We're going home.
Stay back.
Listen to me, Audrey. Pay attention to these last words. Because very soon, you will forget everything.
Let go!
Come find me, Audrey. Come find me, and I'll show you your purpose. I'll show you the truth.
This can't be real.
And now, we die.
What are you doing? Oh, no. No!
Your friend, your protector. For 211 days, you've lived without the ink demon haunting your steps. I banished him away, tore his body in two. In return, I ask just a little favor. Among you, there is a stranger, a young lady. Bring her to me.
Drink too much of that if I were you. It helps patch you up. But the aftertaste, it's not so good. Easy now, I'm not gonna hurt you. It looked like you needed some help.
Don't touch me. What are you? What is this horrible place?
Yeah, I remember my first day down here. I know, it's scary. But you're actually pretty lucky. The machine could have turned you into a searcher.
You mean that thing that attacked me?
No, that's a Piper. And he's part of a gang, so be careful.
I don't understand any of this. I can't think. It hurts.
You'll catch on pretty quickly, if you can stay alive. Lesson one. Searchers don't have legs, and they tend to swarm. Look, it's not good to stay in one place for too long around here. Keep moving, and stay close to the shadows. Take my advice. Head to the upper levels. It's safer there.
Can I come with you?
You can't. I'm sorry. I have a wolf. He doesn't care for strangers.
A wolf?
Like I said, you'll catch on. Good luck. I hope we meet again. Oh, and one more thing. Above everything else, stay away from the ink demon.
What's an ink demon?
Oh, you'll know him when you see him. He likes to smile, and he kills anything that moves.
Wait! What's your name?
They call me Alice. I'm not very fond of it.
I'm Audrey.
Well, Audrey, welcome to the studio. Thank you.
operation, boys, are kind of strange. Every time I come back to work, they put in even more of their pointless gadgets. Last week, they built some kind of, I don't know, electrical towers over near Animation Alley. This week, they added security codes for opening doors. Jeez, what kind of work do they think we do here anyways? Last I checked, we make toys and silly cartoons. This ain't Fort Knox, you know what I mean? Now, 1-451. If Mr. Drew or Mr. Gray asks, you didn't...
Looks like he's having a bad day. Locked again? This is getting old.
Audrey, it's Alice. Can you hear me?
Hello?
Audrey? I'm so glad you're all right.
Alice, I think you and I have very different definitions of all right.
Where are you?
Animation department entrance? But it's locked up tight.
Good. That means you're heading up. Look for anything you can use to break in. Maybe there's a gent pipe nearby. What was that?
There's something in here.
Audrey, find that gent pipe. Now.
There's the gent pipe. Way too dark in there. Need to get the lights working first.
Your face off!
Missing a fuse. Let's see if I can find one.
Kitchen's closed.
What is it? What is it? This isn't happening. This isn't happening. Don't trust me. I want to die.
Well, happy birthday to me.
Hey, where's my order for table four? Come on, guys! Food's cold!
Where did everybody go? Why don't they answer me?
To get that gent pipe. At least now I can defend myself.
I'm gonna rip you apart!
Definitely won't make.
Thank you.
Bendy? You're real? Oh, this is amazing. It's okay. I won't hurt you. I promise. It's okay. See? I'm your friend. I won't hurt you. Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't know that would happen. I promise.
Is that you, Phil? I told you I'm not opening the door until you bring me my pictures. I drew them. I want them back. Thank you.
workers assigned, the animation staff is hired, Archgate Pictures is open for business. As of 9 o'clock this morning, Bendy and all his little cartoon friends now belong to me. I'll admit it's strange owning a dear friend's legacy, but I think Joy would be content knowing it's safely in my hands. You just gotta believe, he used to say. He was such a showman. Well, I believe, Joey. I wholeheartedly believe.
For the way out?
A way out would be nice. Are you stuck in there?
Well, yes, and I'm afraid that means, well, you're stuck too.
Can't you move?
Not an inch. Perhaps you could get me unstuck?
I'll see what I can do.
Say thanks for your feat of rescue. Here's a little gift. Something I've learned. There we are. It's passed on. Now, you can move like me! Goodbye, Bobby! Try not to die!
That was weird.
Hey, Thank you.
You asked for this!
Last week, just how long it takes for us employees to get home every night. When you add in the traffic and the waiting for the elevators, you practically only have a few hours before you have to wake up and come back. So, Joey had them build Artist Rest for us. Now we never have to leave work again, Joey says. Well, I'll admit, it's become quite the hangout spot down here. Almost like it's a own little district. But there's definitely some unsavory stuff going on, too. Smoking, gambling, loud parties, you name it. At all hours of the night, sometimes. For a place that's all about getting some chatter, there sure is a lot of noise around here. thoughts fall to the Joey Drew exhibit we opened last week. Outside one or two of the artists, I don't think I've ever seen a single soul go inside. That's a shame how so many of us refuse to learn from the past. The past can give us our greatest lessons. Ever since we moved in Joey's old things, there's been a strange feeling around Archgate. Like the ghosts of long ago are wandering about.
Thank you.
Are you there? Alice?
Audrey, where are you?
I don't know. It's dark. And I don't know what to do.
Wait there. I'm coming to find you. Just don't move.
I believe there's something special in all of us. Especially you, Audrey.
Who are you?
Don't you know me? Take a good look.
Aren't you...
Joey Drew? In the flesh. Well, so to speak. Come on up. Let's take a little walk. There's something I want to show you. Mind your step. This old place is full of surprises. I should know. I've worked here a long time.
Mr. Drew?
Joey, please.
Joey, what is this place? The studio? These monsters? Am I dreaming?
It's a cycle, Audrey. An ink-stained nightmare, forever stuck on repeat. With just a pencil and a dream, and with a little help from the Jet Corporation, it came into being. From what I gather, it exists in parallel with the outside world, but completely removed from the march of time, and like a record played over and over again, it's begun to crumble, wear down. This studio is a monument to choosing the wrong road. Now, whether it was built for revenge or regret, I don't know. That's my riddle to solve. The truth is, Audrey, someone out there is messing with what's in here. Bad things have begun to emerge from the puddles. Wicked creatures that never came from my pen. The worst ones call themselves keepers. Dangerous, deadly folks. They've taken over the old Jet workshop just beyond the sewers, trying to bring what they call order to this world. Freezing the cycle in place, changing the script. Whatever answers you're looking for, you'll find them there. Look, above all, never forget. You're here for a reason, Audrey. There's always a reason, even when you can't understand it.
You made this world. Why can't you fix it?
Because I'm not the man. I'm just the memory.
Thank you.
Where did you come from? Look, I'm sorry about earlier. I didn't mean to hurt you. And I really don't think you want to hurt me either, right? Good. Let's be friends then, okay? What do you say? You and me? Awesome. Maybe you can help me. I'm looking for the old gent building. What's wrong? Is it a bad place? It's okay. I won't let anything happen to you. We'll go one step at a time. Just you and me. Let's see what we can find.
Thank you. Looks like we need to find an ID card somewhere around here. Any ideas, Bendy? Maybe it's somewhere else. Nope. Not in here. Empty. Well, maybe it's somewhere else. Nothing in here. Let's keep looking. Nothing in here. Let's keep looking. Empty. Well, maybe it's somewhere else. Looks like we found a clue. Creepy in here.
Well, geez, you haven't gotten far.
Don't do that. Wait, how did you get in here?
Oh, I have my ways. So tell me, how goes the journey?
Slow, but I'll get through.
Ah. I see you have your father's never-quit go-getter spirit.
Oh, now you knew my father. Well, newsflash, I didn't even know my father. Or my mother. Or anyone else in my family.
I see, then. You've chosen to forget the past. I can understand that.
What are you talking about?
Look, I don't think you're ready for this. But hang on to your lunch money. There's something I want to show you.
Wait, what are you doing?
All right, Joey. I'm here. Let's see if we can find what you wanted me to see.
Over here. Come have a seat. This won't take long.
Where are we?
A very old place. Full of memories. But never mind all that. There's a little story you need to hear. You ready? Here we go. Once upon a time, Audrey, There was a bitter old man who had lost just about everything.
Joey.
Right. The real Joey Drew. He blamed everyone but himself for his mistakes, but mostly he blamed his old business partner for abandoning their work years and years ago. A man by the name of Henry Stein. Great artist and a good friend. In his anger, Joey used an evil machine to create another world. A world made of paper and ink, where he'd torment his own version of Henry forevermore. But one day, a miracle happened. An angel came into Joey's life. A young woman by the name of Allison Pendle. She didn't visit often, but when she did, she saw something good in Joey no one else could, including himself. Through their friendship, he began to see the world with better eyes. So one day, in Joey's cartoon cycle of hatred, he gave Henry an angel of his own to guide him when things were most dark, to always provide hope. It was then Joey decided to make something new, something he had always wanted, but he could never have. A family. But not a cartoon one. Something real. And after many, many tries, he created something that made him happier than he ever could have imagined. A wonderful, loving daughter. Bright and kind. Almost human. He created you, Audrey.
What? Are you crazy?
Listen, I know it's a lot to believe.
Who do you think you are? I wasn't born from some machine. I'm flesh and blood. I'm not some kind of ink monster.
Just because we're born of darkness doesn't mean we belong to it. We're always free to choose, to believe what we want to believe.
Take me back, right now. I'm not listening to any more of your lies.
Remember who you are, Audrey.
Leave me alone! It's not true. It can't be.
Like a whale, right? But the clockwork march. They clean up the bodies. help me?
For you. I do know how. I really do.
Thank you. That would...
But first, maybe play a game. Oh, I love to play games. I like hide and seek best. Find me, and I'll open the door for you. I promise. Look away while I hide, and no peeking.
Thank you.
open that door for me?
Oh, yes, the door. I think you'll find it's open now. Oh, and also, let me give you something. Something special. Just a small reminder of our game together.
Excuse me. Sir? Can you help me?
You must be really lost to be asking me for help.
I'm just looking for answers. About the Keepers, Wilson, the cycle. Anything could help.
What's your name?
Audrey. What's yours?
Honestly, I've almost forgotten. My name is Henry.
Have you been a prisoner long?
When the Keepers think you're a threat to their plans, they lock you away. Forever. Still, it's given me time to think. Things like, if you haven't eaten in years, you might not be human.
Why would you be a threat to them?
I'm what they call a cycle breaker. Once upon a time, I knew how to start the cycle over. And when that happens, everything begins again. Completely new. Obviously, Wilson and the Keepers don't want that to happen.
How did you do it?
Reset the cycle? Turns out the Ink Demon himself is the key. This world is his, but even he must obey its rules. For now, at least. If you can get him to look at something very specific, it will reset everything.
What is it?
It's just a reel of film. labeled with the words, "The End." I can see it in my mind every day. They keep it upstairs in the pit.
I'll see if I can break in and steal it. Maybe if I reset the cycle, we could make things better for everyone here.
And what about you?
I just want to go home.
So did I. Good luck, Audrey. If you need me again, you know where to find me.
Safe now.
You did this to me. You brought me here. Turned me into this thing. This doesn't make sense. I've never done anything to you.
Open your eyes and look around you. None of this makes sense. Drawn walls, nightmarish creatures, an ancient studio that died out almost 30 years ago. It's all fiction, utter nonsense. And yet, in here, it exists. It breathes. It flourishes. Reality, guided by its master's pen. The foundation for a new reality. We can bleed into our own. Just think of it. Anything we create in here, we can release out there. But first, this world must be controlled, made safe. These angels and demons, are they really life? Or are they just stains? Old mistakes ready to be cleansed away for newer, greater things.
What do you want from me?
I need your help to save my father's life.
What?
This is our star. We'll talk more once we're safely inside. Demon's evil continues to spread. This world has begun to shudder.
Be quiet!
What did you say?
Nothing. It was nothing.
Almost there. Just a quick stop. Won't take but a moment. Stand in the designated location! Lethal object detected. The subject will submit all weapons for further screening. Disarm now. Remain still for examination! The subject is cleared for entry! Welcome to the civilized world. How do you like my signal towers? They nullify the ink demon's powers, so he cannot pass them. I wish I say I invented them, but it seems our friends at the Jet Corporation had a demon problem of their own long ago. And now, my dear, if you'll excuse me, I have a lot to prepare. We'll talk later, I promise. Besides, you must be very tired. A quick rest will do you good. Betty will show you to your room. She's my housekeeper, among other things.
You never actually killed the Ink Demon, did you?
No, he's too powerful to destroy. So we sealed him away. Trapped him in a different form. One that was smaller. Harmless.
Bendy.
It was a fitting prison. Although he seems to have found a way to free himself. But enough talk. We'll deal with that soon enough.
There's some nice fresh blankets all laid out for you. You'll be dreaming in no time.
Wait, Wilson? One more thing. If you needed my help, why didn't you just ask?
Would you have believed me?
Come along, and no more dawdling. This way now. Oh, you're here at last. It's so exciting, finally having you with us. Now, to give you some bearings, we're currently standing in the south wing. Wilson's laboratory is downstairs, and then there's the north wing. The Ink Demon got in there a while ago, and ever since, we've had to keep the north wing locked up tight. I'm afraid it's fallen into ruins by now. All those juicy, lovely books gone to waste. Only keepers go there these days. And they'll tear you apart limb from limb if Wilson isn't with you. So, mind your distance and you'll be just fine. It's not very often I have guests to look after. Especially one I can actually talk to. Almost everyone here either can't speak or they're completely mad. All right, here we are. Best room in the house. You should see where I sleep. Ugh. But this room, oh, just perfect. I saw to every detail. Bed is clean, the bathroom is on the left. Sorry about the stains. I did try my best to get them out. Did you have any questions?
Is it always night here?
It's always dark, if that's what you mean. For as long as I can remember.
Are you very old?
No. As far as I understand it, I'm something quite new. Although, I didn't turn out the way I was supposed to. One in a long line of failed experiments. But Wilson will keep trying.
And do you trust Wilson?
This is the realm of the Ink Demon. The shadow hangs over us all. I don't trust anyone. But Wilson takes care of me, keeps me safe. He once said I remind him of something he called his mother. Tell me, is that a good thing where you two are from?
I'm not sure. I don't think I ever had one.
Well, no matter. Now, I was told to make sure you get some sleep once you got here. So get nice and comfy and relax. I left something on the table that might just help you nod off. It's my own recipe. Works very fast. Just follow the instructions. Carefully.
Thanks, Betty.
Of course. If you need anything else, I'll come straight away. I'm always up. Did you have any questions?
Is it always night here?
It's always dark, if that's what you mean. For as long as I can remember.
Are you very old?
No. As far as I understand it, I'm something quite new. Although, I didn't turn out the way I was supposed to. One in a long line of failed experiments. But Wilson will keep trying.
And do you trust Wilson?
This is the realm of the Ink Demon. The shadow hangs over us all. I don't trust anyone. But Wilson takes care of me, keeps me safe. He once said I remind him of something he called his mother. Tell me, is that a good thing where you two are from?
I'm not sure. I don't think I ever had one.
Well, no matter. Now, I was told to make sure you get some sleep once you got here. So get nice and comfy and relax. I left something on the table that might just help you nod off. It's my own recipe. Works very fast. Just follow the instructions. Carefully.
Thanks, Betty.
Of course. If you need anything else, I'll come straight away. I'm always up.
Gilson. What's a Gilson?
So, I'm looking for a fish? There's gotta be one here somewhere. Thank you. looks like the fish is asleep.
Gotcha!
You can't get away from me, little stinker.
Hello?
I forgot the gilson again, didn't I? And there's some already ground up in the kitchen, too. I'll bring it up to your room straight away, shall I? Oh, and maybe you could put Harold back in his tank. He does so hate the dry air.
Now, just 3 sips of water. 1.
Just a little overwhelmed. It's all right, honey. I understand. It's not every day one gets to bask in the glory
of an angel.
An angel? Alice Angel, to be exact. That's who I am. Sent from above. Impending perfection.
What do you want?
Right to the chase. I like that. The truth is, honey, you're one of a kind. And to put it bluntly, what I want is your face removed, your skin peeled away like paper, and your insides torn out and tossed onto my table. Custom parts, ready for my delicious harvest. And with your generous sacrifice, I'll be beautiful. But for now, let's have fun. Plenty of time for a bloodbath later. Ooh, how about a game? Let's all play a game of riddles.
Riddles? What a wonderful idea!
No. All right, honey. Here's the deal. Behind you is the door to freedom, but it will only be opened if you solve my little puzzle and return to your special chair. Then, I'll throw this heavenly switch here. If you get the puzzle right, you walk away. Get it wrong, you fry. Let's begin.
The fox thinks the rabbit smells of elderberry. I couldn't see them sitting together.
The bird won't have anything to do with the rabbit, but I hear he likes to court danger by sitting next to the fox.
The fox has always hated the bear. They never sit next to each other.
The rabbit never sits with the bird, but he loves the playful company of the bear.
The pompous fox? Well, he wouldn't be caught dead sitting on the left. Far too pedestrian.
My friend the bear always sits next to the bird. After all, they went to school together.
Hold on tight, honey. Here it comes. 3, 2, 1.
Go!
Stop hiding! Start dying! I can do this all day! Come out wherever you are! Always were. Why does this feel so familiar? Are you all right, Audrey?
Alice, I cannot begin to tell you how good it is to see you. And this must be your wolf.
Audrey, meet Tom. He's my protector. My friend.
You both got here just in time. Now I understand why you don't like being called Alice.
The machine creates many of the same forms. At least, on the outside. On the inside, We're all pretty different.
Well, from now on, I'm gonna call you something other than Alice. It just doesn't suit you.
Oh? What do you have in mind?
How about... Allison?
It's not bad. Okay, I'll try it out. But only if you can tell me what in heaven's name you're doing in Wilson's retreat.
Wilson! I almost forgot. I have to get back right away.
Are you crazy? Wilson's our enemy.
Do you even know him? Have you ever talked to him?
I've seen what he's done. That's good enough for me.
Look, it sounds like he has a plan to kill the Ink Demon. For good. And I think he can help us all. I just need to go back and hear him out.
Well, if it's true, you'll both need as much help as you can get. The Ink Demon won't go down without a fight. Tom and I will gather some of our friends. Anyone who's left. Good luck, Audrey.
You too, Allison.
Mind if I take this?
This music box could make a good distraction if I can fix it. Fixed. Now I just need to find a good place to put it. goes nothing.
There you are. Thank goodness. Wilson's waiting for you downstairs in the laboratory when you're ready. But first, can I get your help with something?
Thank you for coming all this way. The Ink Demon is a formidable foe. To truly destroy such a monster, he must be dethroned, humiliated. For months now, I've been working on something that will do exactly that. Cast out the demon, and put a new deity in his place. Stronger, more powerful, and controllable. Together, we just need to unleash our ultimate weapon. Come, let me show you my creation. Isn't he beautiful? Simple, but elegant. A treasure. Powerful beyond anyone. The Ink Demon will fall, and we can have peace at last.
It could work, but it sounds risky. How will we control him? We don't want to repeat Joey's mistake.
No, we don't. All of the factors must be perfect. The right design, the right science, and the right soul. At last your purpose is revealed, Audrey. This is why you're here. With your soul inside him, my creation will live forever.
Stay away from me. You're insane.
Come now, Audrey. Part of you knew this was your path. Leave yourself behind and ascend.
I thought you said we needed to save your father. I thought you had a plan to send me home, to make everything right.
I lied. My father is beyond hope. Perhaps you know him. Nathan Arch, owner of Archgate, industrial genius, business tycoon. For years, I've lived in his reaching shadow. He always had time for the grand creatives of the world, the doers, as he called them. He knew only the best, the biggest thinkers. How could his lowly son ever hope to compete with that? But now, thanks to you, I can. No need to struggle. My signal prevents you from using those devilish powers of yours. And more importantly, keeps the Ink Demon from getting in. It's time to die, Audrey. and live again as a god.
No, not this time.
You were birthed from the darkest
There's always a choice. I know you're in there. Deep behind that evil face. Inside somewhere is my little girl. My Audrey. My greatest creation.
I'm scared. I don't know what's happening.
The past doesn't define you, nor the present. In the end, all those years ago, Joey Drew finally succeeded. He created life. But Audrey, you're so much more than that. You were his family. His daughter. My daughter. And I love you so very much.
Be quiet. The bridge is moving.
Remember who you are, Audrey. Remember.
Your words are wasted. The failure of Joey Drew dies here.
I know you're in there. You don't have to be this anymore. It's never too late. Just a pencil and a dream isn't enough. You have to have heart.
No!
The future is sealed. What do you think you're doing?
I'm starting over.
This is the end.
Time to believe.
Now what?
Need some help?
Henry, you came!
Some battles are worth fighting for, even a million times. Come on, I found a projector up ahead. Run for it!
This battle is mine, and the cycle will continue.
Well then, we'll just have to do better next time. My father once told me that just because we're born of darkness doesn't mean we belong to it. We're always free to choose. And here, at the very beginning, there's a choice to make. My father's cartoon world was now mine, to rule, to watch over, and to protect. I can make the cycle more bearable for my friends inside. But as for me, I'm the first of my kind. Born of ink, but living in flesh. Joey's world is escaping into ours. So, what's next? Who can really say?